I turned the big 5-0 later this year, and it has caused me some emotional disturbance in my mind, to say the least. I find myself revisiting my past experiences, both good and bad. Like everyone else, I would love to have a few do-overs, but life moves forward without regard to decisions we make. I've come to learn that there are 2 days a year we can do nothing about. That's yesterday and tomorrow. We can only live for today and do the best we can. The point to be made is regrets are in and of itself pointless and a waste of time. When I do find myself looking back or reflecting, I unknowingly stare at my hands. I wondered why until the realization of the story my hands can tell about my life. My hands reached out to my mom for comfort as a child. My hands held my father's hand as we walked together through my youth. My hands have thrown baseballs, caught footballs, cast a fishing rod, pulled a trigger on a shotgun while hunting. My right hand was raised when I was 19 as I took an oath to defend my country against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and I joined the United States Army. And just so you know, that oath has no expiration date. My hands have apprehended suspects and assisted those in distress or hurting. My hands have played guitar for my grandmother, and I can still hear her singing the old Red Cross. My hands held my daughters as they entered this world. They also held my tears later in life when they left for college. My hands trembled as I told my mother-in-law she had cancer. My hands have cooked meals for my family and friends. My hands come together in prayer to acknowledge the God I serve. My left hand wears a ring to show the world I love someone special. My right hand wears a class ring to remind me that I represent a university of which I am an alum. Most importantly, it is these hands that God will reach out and take when He leads me home. My hands tell the story of my 50 years, and that is why you may see me looking at them from time to time. You may see me smile, laugh, or even shed a tear or two. No worries. I'm just reliving the stories of yesterday. If I reach out to you for a hug, cook you a meal, or if they come together in prayer and mention your name before God, just know you are adding to my life story. Peace.